Welcome to Wissahickon High School, folks. The Upper Dublin Cardinals will be taking on the Wissahickon Trojans in their fifth game of the season. I'm Ryan Levinson. I will be doing the play-by-play along with Justin Zatelli, who will be your color commentator.
Thank you, Ryan.
Today is set up to be a great game. We're just about ready to start and have the coin toss. Both teams are on the field. All the fans are here. The weather is a bit of a mist.
You could call
on the cooler side.
Dark and stormy, as Snoopy would say it.
Totally agree with you there. Upper Dublin in all white today with the red numbers and sleeves.
We got our captains going out for the coin toss.
Captains from Upper Dublin, Justin Horn, Naeem Huff, Paul Butler, Jason O'Gara.
Ready, let me see.
And the captains for
the captains for Upper Dublin High School today are Naeem Huff, Phil Butler, Justin Horn.
Also, there's some special guests out there for the coin toss. Two members of the original high school graduating class.
And Jason O'Gara.
Justin Horn has been having a great season so far, leading his team to a wonderful 4-0 season so far.
Yes, that is
currently
right.
Undefeated.
And we hope to continue this as we are set up for a good game today.
PIAA and Wissahickon High School place a high emphasis on sportsmanship. So I have your attention for the following PIAA sportsmanship announcement.
We know.
Suburban Life.
We're now going to have the coin toss, waiting for the referees to get set.
Whenever you're done talking, like we're done with this, I'm going to
please remove your hats for the national anthem.
Wonderful performance by students of Wissahickon High School as they sing the national anthem. Great way to represent America.
Amen to that.
Here we go,
Jack Jameson in the end zone getting ready to receive the kickoff.
And Mason Menhart ready to kick off the ball, number 13.
Kickoff will be 7:05 p.m. on Friday, September 30th. What? Fans are ready for the game to get started here.
Quite a good turnout for Wissahickon tonight.
Here's the kick. Caught by... Oh, and it's dropped in the end zone. That's going to be a touchback.
That don't bring it up to the 20-yard line.
Can we switch? We're getting ready for the first play of the night here.
Starting quarterback Justin Horn. 84 in motion.
Here's the snap. Hand it off, goes through, and he's down.
That carry was by number 6.
Number 6 is Mike Cottom.
He's had a really good season so far. Him and Justin Horn both leading their team through those 4-0 victories.
The ball is on the upper level on 30-22. Horn gets set. Here's the snap. Horn goes back, makes the pass, and it's on the ground. The pass is incomplete. It's going to be a 3rd down and 10.
Intended for number 1.
Third and 8 here for Upper Dublin. The ball is on the Upper Dublin 22-yard line. The snap a bit high. Horn's going to run through. He's going.
He's going.
Look at Horn go. He's going to go all the way at the 20, at the 10. Touchdown, Upper Dublin.
That'll
great
put
way
six
to
on the
start
board.
The game.
Amazing run by Justin Horn. Who knew he could run that fast?
That's a wonderful way to start a game. And this shows how Upper Dublin has been playing this whole season. Horn with the touchdown. Chris Barbera is going to go for their extra point here. The
Here's
snap.
The
try. And it's good. Upper Dublin leads 7-0.
7 points on the board for Upper Dublin as they start off really good this time.
We can hear in the stands the Upper Dublin Marching Cardinals proudly playing the alma mater.
Well, the first points were scored just a minute ago, and Upper Dublin's going to kick the ball for Wissahickon to receive. Is she right, Anton? Here's the kick. A little squibber, and it's dropped by the receiver. He's going to be down at the 32, and a flag is thrown. There is a flag on the field. Let's see what the call is. That's going to be a personal foul on Upper Dublin.
Looks like a late hit after the play on number 11.
It's going to be a 10-yard penalty. Marlon Johnson. It's going to be first and 10 at the 46-yard line. Lister Hicken has the ball.
Mike Schlonberger for his first play on the field.
The snap, hand it off. Goes around left, gets through! He's going, and he has stopped by Mike Cottom.
That's a run by Darryl Baldwin.
And tackle by Mike Cottom.
That's going to be good for a first down for Wissahickon. They are down at the Upper Dublin 34-yard line.
That's going to be a gain of 18.
Get set for the next play. Here's
quarterback
the pass.
Sneak.
Quarterback by sneak, and he doesn't get that far. Second and 8 here for Wissahickon as they try to gain yardage.
Wissahickon's quarterback in the shotgun formation.
Up, there's a flag thrown. The false start by the offense, and that's going to be another game. Ball's on the 37-yard line.
Javaris Brown in motion, number 5.
The ball's handed off, and he's going to get knocked down. It's going to be second and 13 as a nice tackle by the Upper Dublin Cardinals.
The running back was Darryl Baldwin, caught in his own backfield.
It's a loss of 1 yard on the play.
It was, I think, Max Weinberg with the tackle.
Max Weinberg with the tackle there. Third and 14. The snap. He runs through, tries to get away, and he's sacked.
Sacked again by this Upper Dublin defense.
That's going to be a fourth down, leaving Wissahickon to have to punt. Good job by the Upper Dublin defense so far. Excuse me, Wissahickon is going to go for it with the 4th and 16.
Shocking play by Wissahickon here. He's in the backfield, he's running. Number 8 is running.
He's tackled by...
Brought down before the first down. That's going to be a turnover on downs for this Upper Dublin defense.
Nice tackle by Zaire Lee, number 71. You can notice the rain starting to slow down, which is a good sign. Justin Horn coming onto the field for Upper Dublin as they take over the ball.
Justin Horn in the shotgun position.
Here's the snap. Hand it off, and he's not going to get that far as he's tackled by the Wissahickon defense. Naeem Huff with the carry there as it's 2nd and 10. Second and 10 for Upper Dublin. There's a flag thrown. Let's see what the flag is on the field. The refs are deliberating as no flag on the play.
An offside penalty against the Trojans.
Oh, never mind. That's going to be an offside penalty against Wissahickon. The ball is on the 35. 2nd and 5.
Justin Horn yet again the shotgun formation with Naeem Huff in the backfield.
Here's the snap. Hand it off to Naeem Huff.
It was a fake. Justin Horn is running the ball.
Justin Horn gets past the 50-yard line. He's going to be at the Wissahickon 51.
That's going to be an Upper Dublin Cardinals first down.
Wonderful carry by Justin Horn. And as we just said, it's a first down on the 46-yard line.
This is very crisp. I like it a lot.
Upper Dublin gets ready. 1st and 10. The snap, hand it off. He's going to go through,
six,
gets a couple yards. Mike Cotton there.
He was brought down by Demarius Brown.
That'll be a gain of 4 by Mike Cottom. Beautiful run.
Ball on the Wissahickon 42-yard line. Horn gets set.
Mike Cottom in the backfield.
And Naeem Huff. And there's a flag thrown. False start by Upper Dublin. It's going to be 2 and 11 on the 47-yard line.
The Cardinals lining up here, 2 and 11. Let's see what they do. Mike Cottom again in the backfield. Justin Horn in the shotgun formation.
The snap.
A run by Mike Cottom.
To Mike Cottom, who gets through just a bit. You can notice that the referees have to keep drawing off the ball due to the light rains here. It makes it a bit harder for both teams to play.
It is now 3rd and 6. The Upper Dublin Cardinals are again lining up.
4 minutes, 57 seconds left in the quarter. Horn's getting ready. The snap. Throws downfield.
Mike Cotto.
Complete. That's going to be another Mike Cardinals touchdown. Mike Cotto.
Is that a second?
That'll be six on the board.
Mike Cottom takes the pass.
Bring us to 12-0. Our Upper Dublin Cardinals.
Make that 13-0. Never mind, it's going to be 12-0. They keep messing the scoreboard here. Barbera lines up for the extra point, and it is good. 13-0. Here, the Upper Dublin Bleachers are really happy here, along with the marching band and the cheerleaders.
Here comes the Upper Dublin Special Teams unit.
The fans of Upper Dublin High School are very happy as they are watching the score on Maps Preps. The kick, it's going to be another swimmer, and it goes out of bounds. And there's a flag on the field.
Go ahead, say it.
Upper Dublin seems to not be getting good punts on the ball. I'm wondering if it's because the ball is wet because of this nasty weather we have tonight.
Yes, that's been happening for the past couple of kicks by Upper Dublin.
It caused the ball to go out of bounds and cost us a flag on the play. Ball in the 38-yard line for Wissahickon Trojans.
First and 10 for Wissahickon. Upper Dublin defense gets ready. The snap handed off to number 11. And he's going to get through and...
Number 11, Marilyn Johnson stopped dead in his tracks.
Upper Dublin has the ball on that fumble by Wissahickon, and the Cardinals offense will be coming right back out where they started.
The fumble was dropped by Marilyn Johnson.
Upper Dublin gets set. They got the ball back.
The snap. Handed off to number 3.
Malik Bootman.
That's his first run of the game.
Yes, it is.
Number 3, Malik Bootman.
Small carry by Malik Bootman, number 3 for the Cardinals.
Justin Horn getting ready for the snap. Malik Bootman in the backfield.
Here's the snap, another running play. Oh, and he fakes it. Whoa. Horn's going to go through, but he's going to get tackled at the 25-yard line.
I got to say, Ryan, that fake even faked me.
There have been a lot of running plays today for the Upper Dublin Cardinals, I've noticed. Only a couple of passes.
One pass in particular was the pass to Mike Cottom, which scored us our second touchdown of the game.
Upper Dublin gets set again.
The snap.
First and 10 at the 26. Hand it off. He's not going to get that far.
Took a couple of guys to bring him down.
I think he went back a couple yards, unfortunately.
Loss of 2.
Loss of 2 yards. It's going to be second and 12.
That run was by Malik Bootman yet again, but he was brought down before he could pass the line of scrimmage. Here we are, Upper Dublin, waiting for the snap. It's an audible.
Horn gets set, the snap. It's going to go for a pass up the center, and it's dropped.
Blocked by number 8 on the defense.
Max Weinbrick, that was who the ball was intended to. Third and 12 for Upper Dublin as the pass was incomplete.
The man who just blocked the ball to Upper Dublin was also the quarterback.
Third and 12 for Upper Dublin.
Let's see if they can pull through. Snap.
The snap. Horn goes back.
He's running.
The pass, and it's way out of bounds.
That'll bring us to 4th and 12. Will they punt it? Will they go for the field goal?
You notice that pass, it was way out of bounds. I think the ball is starting to get a bit wet, which is a problem for any football game, really. And it makes the game very different when it's raining and when the field and when the ball is wet. So hopefully the rain will stop and we won't have to worry about this for too long.
It really shows how the environment can play into any sporting event. It looks like the Upper Dublin Cardinals are going to go for it.
We're going to go for it. 4th and 12 here on the 28-yard line.
Timeout for our Upper Dublin Cardinals. Ladies and gentlemen, we have 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Cardinals currently leading 13-0. It is 4th and 12.
Pornhub.
Looks like the timeout has ended here. Upper Dublin Cardinals still.
No, wait. Look at those sexy cheerleaders on the other side of the field. Just want to fuck them so hard.
I wish you wouldn't say that regardless.
Pepper Lily workout.
Looks like they're still going to go for it.
They're going to get ready. Still going for it after that timeout.
I'll get it. It's 4th and 12.
Two men on the backfield. The snap. Hand it off to Malik Bootman. He's going to get a couple yards there, and he's going to be down at the 21.
A couple yards, but it will not be enough. Justin Horn is tackled about 7 yards short of the first down.
First down, Wes Aiken will take over on the field.
Wizick and lining up.
Here's the snap. It's handed off, and it's going to go right by the line. You're not going to get that far.
Phil Butler making the tackle on
it's a nice tackle by Phil Butler, number 5.
Was the second on the shotgun formation.
The snap a bit high. It's going to be handed off, and he's tackled. A fumble.
Fumbled. Fumble again by number 11, Marlon Johnson.
Let's see what happens here. And Wissahickon gets the ball back. Very close play there as Upper Dublin had the chance.
Still a large loss of yards for Wissahickon. Wissahickon is going on 3rd and 16 here.
Ball on the 17-yard line.
In the shotgun formation.
1:08 left. He's running, trying to get through. The pass is incomplete.
Pass intended for number 13.
If you would like to visit your local drug dealer for the details.
4th and 16 on the 17-yard line for Wissahickon. We're at the 1-minute mark for the first quarter ending.
Mason Menhart of Wissahickon back there for the punt.
The snap. It's punted. Doesn't really go that far, and it's going to be stopped at the 52. He's running, trying to get through. A nice spin move by number 7, and he gets down at the 45-yard line. George Weems on that couple-yard carry. There's a personal foul on Upper Dublin, roughing the kicker. It's not good for Upper Dublin with 49 seconds left. They still have a lead. Horn is getting set. The Upper Dublin line gets ready. Here's the snap, and he gets stopped. Down at the 45. 40 seconds left here for the first quarter.
The clock quickly going down. We'll see if it's enough time for a score.
Second and 6, 16 seconds left in the first. It's going to be run against the right side. It's going to go out of bounds.
Daryl Baldwin with the carry for Wissahickon.
And that's going to do it, folks. The first quarter is in the books with Upper Dublin leading 13-0. Play of the quarter. It's a false start by the Wissahickon Trojans. It's going to be a 10-yard penalty. Third and 8. Let's get set. Wissahickon with the ball.
Wissahickon getting set. Quarterback.
Here's the snap.
Quarterback dropping back. Running away from
back.
Pressure.
The pass.
Throws the ball away.
Oh, intercepted
by Mike Cullen.
Number 6, Mike Cullen intercepted the ball.
He's going.
At the 40.
At the 50.
And he's
going
to be down at the 58-yard line. Wonderful interception by Upper Dublin.
Beautiful interception by Mike Cottom.
Upper Dublin will get the ball back here.
Like usual.
I have one in here. Here, come over here.
11:39 here. Upper Dublin's going to get the ball back. We are getting ready here with Upper Dublin with the ball.
Upper Dublin Cardinals lining up. Justin Horn in the backfield.
The snap handed off. It's not going to get that far. Phil Butler on the carry. They only get 1 yard there. It's going to be 2nd and 9. Clock ticking, 11:20 left.
This is Phil Butler's first carry of the game.
Upper Dublin gets set here.
Number 11, JT Breslin in the slot.
The snap. Here's the pass.
Long pass to J.T. Breslin.
And it's good.
It's a touchdown.
He gets it there. J.T. Breslin. Touchdown.
Beautiful.
Wonderful touchdown by J.T. Breslin.
From a beautiful pass from Justin Horn.
Upper Dublin is having a great game today. They lead 19-0, and hopefully This extra point.
We'll see if he can make it 20-0. Barbera with the kick. Barbera with the kick. And it's no good. The extra point is no good. That leaves us at 19-0.
Barbera misses the extra point for the second time today.
But there's a flag on the play.
There's a flag on the field.
Let's see what that flag is. There are no teams on the field right now. The referees are figuring out what happens. Both teams will head back on to the field. Upper Dublin will be punting the ball. Anton Lloyd will be in the end zone for Wissahickon.
Upper Dublin getting ready for the punt. His kick.
Punt by Upper Dublin. Kickoff. It's going to be in the end zone for a touchback.
That'll start with Wissahickon out on the 20-yard line. Both teams lining up here.
The snap, and there's a flag. Let's see.
That'll be a flag on the play. False start by the offense. 5-yard penalty. That'll bring them to 15. 15 yards. No, no. That'll bring him to the 15-yard line, first and 15.
Upper Dublin will get set.
Here's a snap. Oh, it's a
the
running
snap
play.
Snap is handed off, and he's going to get pulled down. Doesn't get that much yardage there.
That was Andre Mack on the carry.
Run by Andre Mack.
Naeem Huff barely ran over the guy there. It's going to be 2nd and 7. They gained 8 yards on that play. Both teams are set here. Let's see what happens. Here's the ball handed off.
Handed off.
And go in the middle of the field. His turn, and he falls down on Lloyd. 19-yard line. Anton Lloyd trying to get some yardage there.
Tackle by Naeem Huff.
It's going to be 3rd and 11. Clock is ticking at 9:30.
What it ain't though, boy. Third and 11 for the Wissahickon Trojans. We'll see if they can make a first down here.
Both teams are set here. Let's see what happens. The snap a bit high. He's going to run through. Then doesn't get that far.
The quarterback tried to run the ball, number 8, with a gain of, I would say, about 2.
It's going to be 4th and 11. 4th and 8, excuse me.
My bad. A gain of 3.
You can notice the rain starting to pick up just a bit. It's a bit misty, but you can definitely feel it out here at Trojan Stadium.
Mike Cottom and George Weems getting ready to receive this punt.
Here's the punt, and it's going to be low, and it's going to be picked up.
The punt picked up by George Weems.
Fumbles it for a bit. George Weems gets it.
Covered by number 7, George Weems.
All the black kids are having a good game today.
Pretty cool.
Upper Dublin waiting for the snap.
And offside, that's going to be offside. Very clear by Wissahickon. First and 5 for Upper Dublin on that offside by Wissahickon.
Justin Horn, yet again, waiting for the snap. Malik Bootman
and
in the back.
There's another flag.
Yet another flag on the field.
This one goes against Cardinals.
The same thing with Upper Dublin, just an offside. So it's going to get pushed back to 1st and 10, right where they started. Ball on the 45-yard line. Snap gets ready on the 45. Here it is, handed off to number 3. He's going to get through! But there's a flag on the field. A lot of flags here tonight.
Run by Malik Bootman yet again.
That's going to be a holding penalty against Upper Dublin.
Baby Slayer, 1, 2, 3, Rose Lamouli.
Upper Dublin in the huddle there. Let's see what happens. Clock starts.
Upper Dublin after that penalty is now at 1st and 13.
So many flags in the last couple of plays.
Snap. Given off to Malik Bootman yet again. A beautiful run. Picks up the first down and he's still going.
Look at him go!
Comes down at the 32.
Wonderful running as he pushed through that Wissahickon defense. First down at the 26-yard line. Wonderful running by Malik Bootman.
We're better than this. Why did I say 30? Why did I say 32? I'm about 32.
Last play was Malik Bootman.
Let's see what happens here. Upper Dublin, hopefully he can score at least one more touchdown in the first half. Here's the snap, there's a flag, and I think it's a false start and or offside by Wissahickon.
You know, Ryan, I'm getting really tired of these flags.
You know what, yeah. What can you do? They're tedious. Most of the flags have been in the second quarter. First and 15 for Upper Dublin, coming out of the huddle. Let's see what happens here, folks. Snap the horn, it's flipped
back. To Mike Cottom.
He's getting through Mike Cottom! Down at the 19-yard line.
Mike Cottom turning on the afterburners there.
The Wissahickon defense is just having a hard time stopping Upper Dublin High School.
I would have to agree with you there. It does not look like they can stop them. It is now second and four for our Upper Dublin Cardinals.
Let's see what happens here. Hopefully we can get another touchdown and 6 minutes left.
Another run.
Gets a couple yards there.
Mike Cottom with the carry. Picking up the first down. Ball is on Wissahickon's 14-yard line. First and 10.
Up and taking their time here.
Breaking out of the huddle.
Let's see what happens here.
Justin Horton, the shotgun.
The snap. Hand it off. It's going to get through number 21. Nice gain of yardage there as they get closer to another Cardinals touchdown.
Number 21, Nick Sonetto with the carry. Nick Sonetto's first carry of the game. Beautiful run. Gain of 9. Brings us to 2nd and 1.
Second and one here. Upper Dublin coming out of their huddle. Let's see if they can get the touchdown on this play.
On Wissahickon's own 5-yard line. Let's see if Wissahickon can defend against this Upper Dublin offense.
The snap. Goes through, and you can put it on the board for Upper Dublin.
Touchdown to Phil Butler. His first of the game.
The Cardinals are dominating here as the score becomes 25-0.
Gotta say, there's nothing better. There's not a better feeling in the world than seeing your local sports team kill another local sports team.
Let's see if Chris Barbera can make the extra point. He's had trouble today, missing two and making one. Here's the kick, and it is not good. He is 1 for 3, or 1 for 4, excuse me.
Four minutes and 40 seconds left in the half. Score is currently 25-0. Upper Dublin leading.
The Cardinals might want to put in Ryan Brady as their place kicker, though he is a backup. The win factor here at Trojan Stadium could be stopping the Cardinals from getting those field goals and extra points.
I feel bad for Chris Barbera.
It's just tough with this weather dealing with what's going on today.
Abraham Cardinals on the field for the punt.
Number 62 gets the kick. Bit low.
Long back.
And it's going to be caught at the 20-yard line. He goes back towards the sidelines. He goes back even more. He's trying to run forward, but he will not get that far.
Number 10 finally.
He runs into his own player. That was
Rasheed Rice. You see him run into his own player there.
First down, Trojans.
First and 10 at the 27-yard line.
Kick returned by Rasheed White.
Chase Utley, you are the man. Home run, Chase Power.
Let's get ready. Wissahickon trying to score. They haven't scored yet. 4 minutes, 28 and a half. Here's the quarterback.
Number 8, the quarterback. The
pass, and it's taken away.
Pass intended for number 22 to Tyler Casso.
Incomplete pass by the Trojans. It's going to be second and 10. The fans are trying to battle through this game. It is a bit tough to watch, though. I do have to admit that. If you drove in a 1990 Camaro, your alarm is going off, so please come to the parking lot. You will be allowed back in. Do not worry. Love this job.
Wissahickon lining up for the snap.
Want to make everyone very happy. I know.
Snap from Wissahickon.
The snap
drops back, way back.
And it's incomplete. Nice defense by Upper Dublin.
Pass intended for Marilyn Johnson.
Did I say that Marilyn is a woman's name? In fact, that is my grandmother's name.
This brings us to 3rd and 10 on Wissahickon's own 28-yard line.
Let's get ready. 3rd and 10 here. Trojans cannot get anything tonight.
Let's see if the Wissahickon Trojans.
The snap. He's going to go for the pass yet again. And it's incomplete. Pass. Went right through his hands, number 11.
Marilyn
and that's
going to
be a 4th down.
Pass incomplete. Bring up 4th down.
Pass intended to Marilyn Jones. Slipped right through his hands. His sweaty hands.
Let's see what happens here. They're at the 28, so I guess that they're going to punt this ball.
They're bringing
Seems the coaches are very mad in the press box upstairs.
Yes, they are, Ryan. Yes, they are. Bringing out the punting unit. Number
Here's
11 with the
punt,
kick.
A nice punt. It's going to go down right at the 45. And it's going to stop.
Wissahickon will tap the ball. Stopped at the 48. Cardinals lining up at the 44-yard line. First and 10. Justin Horn in the backfield.
The snap to Horn. He's running through. Look at him go. Nice running by number 5. Naeem Huff.
Naeem Huff is number 4. What are you doing?
Gain of 9.
So we can get it.
That's going to be great.
Oh my God.
We love you very much, Upper Dublin.
Upper Dublin Cardinals lining up for the snap. Snap, Justin Horn. Give it.
He's going to keep going.
Gives it up.
Look
to
him go.
Number five.
He's down at the 20-yard line.
Number five, Phil Butler.
Phil Butler brought down by Jabari Brown.
He was brought down by Javarius Brown. Nice running by Upper Dublin.
Phil Butler has been having a wonderful game so far. As well as the whole Upper Dublin Cardinals running team. As that is their primary source of yardage in this game.
Here's the snap to Horn. It's going to be handed off to 33, who gets a couple yards there. 33 is Lucas Roselli, the sophomore.
Lucas Roselli was dropped, brought down by Justin Cooper.
Fisher's timeout.
It's going to be a timeout here. To continue regulation here, Upper Dublin had an injury lasted about 2 minutes, but we're ready to get back.
2 minutes left in this half.
Horn has the snap. He's going to throw it, and it's just a bit outside of his reach.
Pass intended for Jalen? To Jalen Heim. Intended for Jalen Heim.
After our food.
I'm on.
Getting ready for the snap.
Here it is. Number four has the ball. He's going to try to get through that line. He doesn't get that far.
Hand it off to Naeem Huff.
That was Butler again.
Time slowly expiring here in the first half, bringing us down to 1 minute.
Is it 1 minute?
Upper Dublin, fourth and three. They're going to go for it on Wissahickon's own 14.
Let's see what happens here with Justin Horn getting ready. Here's a snap. It's handed off to number four, and it's handed down. That's going to be a turnover.
Carried by Naeem Huff to try to get that first down. He did not get the first down. Oh, wait. Never mind. He did pick up the first down.
Come on, God. If there's a God.
Josh, you're curious. There's a God.
I yet again stand and corrected. He did not pick up the first down. My bad.
The ball is turned over to Wissahickon.
On their own 14-yard line.
There's the whistle. The clock will start up. And the snap. Quarterback is back at the five. Here's the pass. And it's... He doesn't even see it. And he just drops it. It goes right past him. That must make the Wissahickon crowd and coaching staff not happy.
Pass intended for Jamarius Brown. pushed out of bounds before he could catch the ball. Upper Dublin's defense lines up. Oh, that was close. Almost had an offside. Snap to Wisconsin. Handed off to number 5. He's running to the outside. Let's see if he can make it past the line of scrimmage. He's being pushed back by the defense. What? Number 3 on our Upper Dublin Cardinals defense. Fumble recovery for a touchdown.
Who was it?
Malik Bootman for the fumble recovery and to get the touchdown. That'll bring us to 31-0. Ryan Brady for the extra point this time. Here's the snap. Here's the kick. Oh! No good.
Okay, set.
Apparently, the ball is very wet today. I can tell. I can tell the field is very wet. It's glistening. With kick.
Careless?
I was the one who was careless.
Yeah, it was you. The mic.
Right? 30 seconds left in this half. After that touchdown brings us to 31-0. Upper Dublin Cardinals. Upper Dublin's punting team coming out to the field. Number 62 for the punt. For the kick. Recepted by number 11. He pushes through. It looked like a fumble on the field, but I could not get a good look at it. Let's see what happens.
There's 19 seconds left. Upper Dublin 31. Wissahickon still not able to score. The ball is given back to Wissahickon. Down on the first. No, that's wrong. Let's wait for an update on the field. 32-yard line, excuse me.
19 seconds left in this half. Well, let's see if Wissahickon can make some noise. Wissahickon lining up. 3 receivers. 1 running back.
Let's see what happens. The Man, snap.
They're gonna, the quarterback is going to run the ball, but he's not getting past
through,
number 8.
But it's not going to really get him that far. Nice tackle by Max Weinbrick. And that's going to end the first half of this game. Upper Dublin leads 31 with the Trojans 0. I'm Ryan Levinson.
And I'm Justin Zatelli.
And we'll be right back as soon as the halftime show is over. Thank you.
Thank you.
And welcome to the halftime show brought to you by Citizens Bank. Good banking is good citizenship. We are here at the halftime, Upper Dublin versus Wissahickon, and the score is 31-0 Upper Dublin. They are absolutely dominating today.
I mean, it seems like Wissahickon doesn't even have a team out there.
Yeah, I totally agree. It's been a rough game for Wissahickon.
A very rough game.
Let's talk about Upper Dublin and their performance. The thing that I've noticed the most is a lot of missed field goals and extra points. Most of them by Chris Barbera and one of them by Ryan Brady, the backup kicker.
I have to agree with you that Chris Barbera is currently 1-for-4 with extra points, and Ryan Brady brought in on the last extra point taken, 0-1.
Yes, and I'm pretty sure, based off of normal knowledge, that it's because of the rain. We've had rain throughout the whole game so far. It's been off and on, and that's the main problem. I mean, it's tough to play in the rain.
As you can see behind us, the rain is starting to come down a little bit harder, as it looks like mist down on the field. The field is very wet right now. The bleachers are very wet. It's very slippery.
And you can see the Wissahickon Trojans are coming out, hopefully to fix this game and score at least 7 points.
I mean, considering we're Upper Dublin fans, I don't think hopefully anything will happen.
You're not supposed to say that. Okay. Let's get ready for kickoff here.
The Wissahickon Trojans are ready to receive the ball.
And Matt Shields will be kicking the ball off to start the second half.
Matt Shields will be kicking the ball to start off.
Here's the kick. Beautiful kick downfield. Recepted by number 10 on the Trojans. Flag on the play. Number 10 is brought out of bounds at the 25-yard line. There was a flag on that play. Let's see what it was.
That's going to be a holding penalty. Cardinals get set. They're going to start off at the 11-yard line. 1-10.
They will be starting at the 11-yard line because of a holding penalty during the kickoff. What happens.
Here's the snap.
That last carry was by Javaris Brown, who lost 1 yard on the carry. It is now 2-11. Wissahickon in formation. Snap the ball.
Go ahead.
Hand it off to number 5. Number 5 brought down by Naeem Huff. That carry was by Javaris Brown yet again, with a loss of 1. Gain of 4, my bad. It's now 3rd and 7. Wissahickon lining up, waiting for the snap. Number 8. Here's the snap. Ball thrown downfield to number 2. Number 2 drops the ball. Pass intended for Anton Lloyd.
Sean Labor's pass incomplete.
Pass incomplete to Anton Lloyd. It is now 4th and 7th. They're going to bring out the punter. Mason Menhart for the punt. Mike Cottam and George Weems ready to receive for Upper Dublin. Here's the kick. Beautiful kick downfield. rolling towards Mike Cottam, picked up by Wissahickon. That'll be down at the 51-yard line. Here comes Justin Horn back onto the field, leading his team to 31-0 from the first half. Let's see if he can make some more noise through the second half. Justin Horn in the shotgun position. Naeem Hoff in the backfield. Here's the snap. Looks to the right.
I'm back.
Pass complete to Jalen Heem.
I'm back.
For a gain of 5. It's now 2nd and 5 after that pass completion to Jalen Heem, number 1.
The rating here, and the referee spots the ball at the 44-yard line here after he had to dry it yet again. By the way, my name is Josh Portney. I'm filling in for Ryan Levinson, who is currently MIA eating food because it is a cold one and he needs to, everyone does, and everyone needs to take a break because it is really bad, really bad out here. So that was a carry for a couple yards. Brings it to 3rd and 3 for Wissahickon, or for Upper Dublin, I'm sorry. The referee spots it down at the 42-yard line. I'd say 42 in inches, maybe. It looks like it's in the middle. Let's see what the...
I'd say the Upper Dublin Cardinals have been doing very well on third down conversions. Let's see how they do on this one. And the snap to Horn. Give it to number 21, Nick Sonetto, for a carry.
There's a scuffle. There's a scuffle, and finally it is brought down.
Brought down before the first down. That'll bring them to 4th and 3.
Fourth and 3 here for Upper Dublin Cardinals, and it looks as though they may go for it. Why not? Because, you know, why not? It is 31-0.
Upper Dublin for fourth down conversions is currently 1-1. Let's see how they do on this one. We got Phil Butler in the backfield. And Malik Botman to the left. Handed off to Phil Butler, who is quickly taken down by this Wissahickon defense.
Wissahickon got some momentum here with a good 3-and-out defense here. They tried, Upper Dublin tried, to keep this drive alive, but the Wissahickon defense stopped them right on the 44-yard line. 43 is where he's going to spot it, actually.
So, Josh, that'll be a turnover on down. Wissahickon will have the ball on the 43-yard line. It is now 1st and 10.
It looks like Wissahickon came out of the locker room with more passion than Upper Dublin did. Oh, I stand corrected. There's a flag down.
Flag on the play.
But that was a great play by number 4. Naeem Hoff, who's also a captain. Naeem Hoff with the... the tackle here.
Flag on the field.
Andre Mack taken down for that from that carry. We'll see what the
foul, face mask against Upper Dublin, automatic first down.
Face mask on Upper Dublin. We do not like to see those personal fouls. They are a big hit in our defense. That'll be an automatic first down and a huge gain of yards for Wissahickon.
15 yards, a full 15 yards here on this face mask penalty.
The coach cannot be happy about that, Josh.
Absolutely not. I am sure Mr. Stover, Brett Stover, is furious. This is the same Brett Stover we're talking about who led Upper Dublin to the championships last year with an unfortunate loss.
Naeem Huff makes the stop in the backfield.
Javaris Brown with the carry, taken down by Naeem Huff for a gain of none.
So yeah, we have Corey Stover back. Corey Stover is the manager of the team now. That's the same Corey Stover who was the quarterback of last year. He's the manager, and he's doing very well.
Ryan Stover.
My apologies, it was Ryan Stover. Look, there's a scuffle here, and it's hard to see who has the ball, but it looks like Wisconsin maintains.
Josh, it's currently 2-12 here. Where's Hicken on the 47? 3rd and 13. Let's see how they do on this third down conversion. Haven't seen them doing that well, but we'll see how they do.
Ryan, we'll cut that part. That was terrible. You gotta know that guy. He's in Towson now.
Oh! Oh! Pressure!
Pass intended for number 11. He was in.
Pressure.
Pass completed to Marlon Johnson.
Kyer Lee. Kyer Lee with a great, some pressure on the quarterback. And it's moved the change, however, because the Wisconsin quarterback's able to get out of that situation very quickly and very effectively.
But Kyer Lee made a great pass to number 11, Marlon Johnson, who completed the pass, giving them the first down they needed from that third down situation. They are now at the 30-yard line, 1-10 to go.
There's a timeout on the field with a score 31-0 here at Trojan Field.
Timeout on the field here with the score 31-0 at Trojan Field here. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll be back.
Upper Dublin lining up on the field for the defense. Ooh, offsides, Upper Dublin.
Offsides on Upper Dublin here called.
Offsides, Upper Dublin.
That'll be a 5-yard gain for Wissahickon. I gotta say, Josh, the Cardinals cannot be taking penalties this often. It is not a good look.
No, it's definitely not, and especially if we're looking towards the playoffs here.
It's not, really, it is not, because especially if we're looking towards the playoff here.
Wissahickon getting towards the red zone. Ball handed off to number 2.
Anton Lloyd on the carry.
Anton Lloyd.
Gain of a couple, bringing up.
It is now 2nd and 2. Wissahickon nearly in the red zone. We'll see what they do next. Third quarter ticking down to 5 minutes remaining. Still 31-0. Here's a snap. Handed off to number 3 for the carry. That'll be a gain to give them the first down.
That's the Trojan first down.
Andre Mack with the carry to pick up that Wissahickon first down. It is now Wissahickon's ball on the 17th yard line. My bad.
You want a break?
I'm fine right now.
Here's the snap. Quarterback spin down at the 9-yard line. Or 14-yard line. This is Ryan Levinson back in action here. Had a bit of a mishap earlier, but it's all good.
Josh Portney now moving on to the camera position.
Woo! Woo! Oh, wait, the camera's on. Hello!
Oh, it's getting on yours.
Wissahickon on the 14-yard line in the red zone. It's 2-7. Second down and 7.
Second and 7 here on the 14-yard line.
Let's see what they do.
Here's the snap. There's two flags on the field and it's
on the
down.
Play, yeah.
Let's see what these calls are.
You'd hate to see a penalty on Wisconsin because they're so close to sweet, sweet touchdown. That's it.
Hello. Josh, I turned it off.
Illegal block from Wissahickon there. Second and 7 on the 14-yard line.
Pornhub. Oh, wait, I think his is on. Turn your mic off. La-la-la-la! La-la-la-la! Why?
Let's go. Let's get back in this game on the 20-yard line. Second and 22. Quarterback at set. The snap. He's going to go for a pass. Let's see what happens here.
Oh, pressure
for
back.
Number 55. He runs up, tries to get through, and he's out of bounds.
That'll be a gain of 0. Wissahickon now at 3rd and 22. It's a very long third down conversion for them.
Excuse me, it's 3rd and 27.
3rd and 27, my bad. 3rd and long.
Let's see what happens here.
Let's see what they make of it.
He's set. Goes the pass.
Quick pass
and
to number 22.
Incomplete.
Incomplete.
Almost hit the ground there, and it did hit the ground there. No good. Fourth and 27. Looks like they're going to punt. Let's see what happens here. Fourth down and forever.
Looks like the quarterback is staying on the field.
Oh my gosh. Be surprised.
I think
it looks like they're going to go for it here, folks.
That is, I would not have done that if I was the coach.
I think they're too close to the other side of the field, to be honest.
Here's a snap.
Here's a snap. Check.
And
he's sacked! Up and up in!
Number 8, Max line break with the sack.
Wonderful play by Up and Up in! And Up and Up in will get the ball!
Turnover on downs.
Here comes Justin Horn. First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
How did I do? Do you guys need rides home? Wait, do you?
There's the whistle. It's and Up and Dublin will call a timeout.
Water boys coming out into the field to hydrate the players.
Big boy.
When's the Jewish holiday? Sunday. No, Sunday night.
So we pay a tribute to all the Jews out there. It is Rosh Hashanah on Monday, October
2nd.
Third, maybe.
Please be sure to thank your nearest Jew for giving you off time.
Please wish all of your Jewish friends a Happy New Year, as it is Rosh Hashanah coming up very soon. Shana Tova to all of our Jewish listeners and viewers. Thank you.
This timeout might have given the Trojans time to think about their defensive plan, because their defense has not been looking that good this game. Two running backs in the backfield. George Weems on the left. JT Breslin in the slot position. Justin Horn running the ball. Brings it to the 40-yard line. First down, Upper Dublin Cardinals.
Wonderful fake handoff.
Hell, Upper Dublin. Where'd you get this? With shipping?
Justin Horn breaking the huddle.
Let's get going here. First and 10 on the 39-yard line.
Naeem Huff to his right. JT Breslin in the slot.
The snap hands it off to Huff. Huff is going to get through. Let's see what happens. Huff, and he's brought down at the 33-yard line.
Naeem Huff brought down by Javarius Brown.
One must think whether Upper Dublin is willing to go for the 41-0 route like they have been doing for the past two other games. Now, the first two games of the season, as you know, they won 41-0, consecutively 41-0. The other team did not get 1 point. So it's 31-0 right now with 2 minutes left in the third quarter. One must think that Upper Dublin is going to try to repeat that again.
Here's a snap. Hand it off to Naeem Huff again.
That's Huff again.
For a gain of about two.
Brought down by Kyle Moynihan.
I totally agree on that. Never mind, I apologize.
No, my point.
Third and two at the 30-yard line. 1 minute left.
Looks like the Trojans' defense is actually slowing down the Upper Dublin offense just a little bit more than they had before.
Let's see what happens here.
Handed off to number...
He's going to go number back a couple yards for the fourth Whoa. Down.
Flag down and after the play.
Let's see what this flag is for. Clock has stopped at 49.8 left in the third quarter.
That looked like a personal foul for me. To me. The refs are deliberating.
A personal foul in Upper Dublin, unfortunately.
Naeem Huff was all the way at the bottom of that dog pile. I'm not sure how we got a personal foul from that play.
There have been a lot of penalties tonight. Very strange. Very weird penalties. Let's continue this game. Hopefully we can keep this shutout going through the end of the third quarter.
Barbera out there for the punt. Here's the snap. High snap. Nice kick, though. Nice and high. To number two.
That's a penalty! Come on!
Coach is yelling up here in the box. Looked like a penalty, but the referees are not calling it. Very strange night with the referees.
I can hear people in the stands yelling for a penalty. Is that because the kick returner called a fair catch and then kept running for a little bit? Kick return by Matt Silverman from WIS.
30 seconds on the dot left. First and 10 at the 17-yard line.
I'm very confident in our defense to be able to stop
the snap.
Jason Hicken from getting any touchdowns.
Hand it off. He's not going to get that far. Clock's still running at 21 seconds.
Time is expiring. 20 seconds remaining.
I love this.
Second and five. They're
10 seconds left.
Just going to run out the clock here.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1.
And that is the third quarter, 31-0, Upper Dublin. Three quarters are in the books. We'll be right back. Let's get ready to start off the fourth quarter. 31-0, Upper Dublin. I'm Ryan Levinson alongside Justin Zatelli.
I'm Justin Zatelli alongside Ryan Levinson.
You hear the
and
band
I'm
starting back up.
The camera here.
The Trojans have the first down with a gain of 12, 22-yard line, first and 10.
Wissa Hicken, 1-for-1 in completions on this drive. So far, doing well against this Upper Dublin defense. Let's see how they go.
Let's see. The snap. Doesn't get that far.
Hand it off to number 3.
Mack with the carry.
Andre Mack. Jason O'Gara with the tackle, number 65. It's now 2-8
clock is
for Wissa Hicken on their own 36.
Here's a snap. Goes back, way back. Up and coming up.
Right on the play.
He gets set. Oh! He throws it right before he hits the ground.
But there was a flag on the play, Ryan. Let's see what impact it has.
That's going to be holding against Wissa Hicken on that play.
It's going to be a loss of 5. Offense and defense lining up. Here's the snap.
Here's the snap.
Hand it off to number 2.
You both did good, so I'm going to put it
on. Anton Lloyd. Carry by Anton Lloyd. Number 2. You can hear over on the student section for Upper Dublin, the marching Cardinals playing proud and loud.
Let's see what happens here. 3rd and 26 on the 17-yard line. 10:15 left of the quarter. The snap.
Drops back. Time in the pocket.
He's running.
He's still running at the 20, 25,
and he's going to go...
He's going to go
down.
Out of bounds, baby. Flag on the
play. And there's a flag on the play.
I'm thinking it's a personal foul.
I'm thinking that too, Justin.
after the play. Let's see. You gotta love this high school football vibe.
Kissing, it was a personal foul and a 15-yard penalty. Yep, there you go. First and 10 on what looks to be the 44-yard line. Yep.
The snap.
Here it is.
Handed off to number 5.
Tries to get through, doesn't really get that far.
About a gain of, I would say about 3.
Let's see, is that the 44?
Brown on the carry, finally taken down by number 71, Zaire Lee.
Good job by Zaire Lee getting the runner down.
Carried by Javarius Brown. He's been having a pretty good game against this Upper Dublin defense.
Gain of 3, bringing up a 2nd and 7.
47-yard line, 2nd and 7.
9 minutes remaining in this fourth quarter.
The snap. Thrown away.
Special teams coming on the field.
We apologize for broadcast interruption. We may have not recorded the last 3 to 4 minutes of the game because of broadcast interruption. Thank you very much.
What you may have missed during the break is that Wissahickon actually got on the board with 6 points.
And they did try to go for the 2-point conversion. It successfully failed, I guess you could say.
I guess you could say that. Successfully failed. Quite an oxymoron, isn't that, Ryan?
Ms. Stern helped me out learning all that stuff. Thanks to Ms. Stern and Mr. Cobb.
It was a fake run play. A fake extra point run play.
Let's see what happens here. Number 13, Thomas Higgin, is talking to the referee.
Special teams on the field, it looks like. I'm not sure what's happening right now. 7:33 on the clock.
Chewy baby.
We're about halfway through this fourth quarter.
Can you come?
Wissahickon getting ready to kick off to Upper Dublin. Jack Jamison in the end zone. Ball's going to go past him. He's going to go down to the 10.
As long as he can
get through that defense, and he's taken down at the 25-yard line.
Jack Jamison with the return from 10 to 25. There was a personal foul on Wissahickon. That's why the ball was kicked off from where it was back in the end zone. We're starting here at Upper Dublin's 25-yard line.
25-yard line for Upper Dublin. Baby Slayer.
Seems like a stoppage in play. The water boys are coming out, hydrating their team. Team players there.
What's the matter with the clothes I'm wearing? Can't you tell that the fire's too wide?
Ladies and gentlemen. Minutes, 13 seconds left here in the ballgame. Up and up and leading 37-6. Welcome to everyone viewing us right now. We welcome you to Wissahickon High School.
I want to give a shout out to Ben Poland, who is watching this from home. Ben Poland, we're giving you a shout out here from Trojan Stadium in Wissahickon.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday and have a nice night.
The clock is still ticking here, 6:46. Ball is on the 26-yard line. What? First and 10. Everyone gets set. The snap is a bit high. He's going to try to run around there. And he's not going to get that far.
Looks like number 9, Julian Gimble, actually took the snap on that play.
Chase Preston with the carry.
And Chase Preston coming in for his first catch of the night.
Looks like tackle was by Javon.
Julian Gimble came into this ball game right now. He's taken over at quarterback with 6 minutes left in this game.
Chase Preston with his first carry of the game in this late fourth quarter. Julian Gimble escaping pressure. He got taken down by Wisconsin.
Clock still ticking here.
We arrive here in Wissahickon again, joining you live from Trojan Stadium. Trojan Stadium beside the Marching Cardinals and the Trojan Wissahickon playing their amazing band here.
The punt!
Here's the punt!
Hits the ground.
Bounce back.
And it's going to be picked up by Upper Dublin. Down at the 43-yard line. 4:42 left in the ballgame. You hear the marching band of the other team trying to get their crowd pumped up during this big deficit for them.
As you can hear,
4:42, the clock had stopped here.
As you can hear right next to us, where's the Hickens marching band playing loud and proud for the team? Both teams lining up for this play.
Everyone gets set here.
4:30 remaining in this last quarter.
The snap is handed off to number 5. He's going back. Not going to get that far.
Number five taken down. Loss of yard.
You said you were like fucking 50 times.
Second and 15 for Wissahickon. Stoppage in play. Timeout for Wissahickon.
Getting set to start up again. Whistle blows, clock starts, 3:55.
Resuming play here.
He's with the ball.
Stadium. Here's a snap.
It's going to be a long pass. And it's complete.
Number 11.
Number 11, nice catch. There's a flag on the field.
And he's hitting so many blockers.
Run very far and in there for a touchdown.
To the 5-yard line.
No touchdown. Excuse me. He gets down right by the end zone.
There was a flag on the play. We'll see what happens.
There's a flag. Let's see what this is for.
What Ben say? Not yet. Oh, yeah. I want to add your Christian friend.
Reception by Marlon Jones, number 11. The refs are deliberating. There was a flag on the last play in which Marlon Jones.
There's a penalty.
Like a personal foul.
Fans not happy based on this loss so far.
I agree, the fans are not happy.
Yeah, they're getting a bit rowdy here. I think they're a bit upset based off the score. Getting set, there's the whistle. 3 minutes, 30 seconds left in this game. Upper Elbin crushing Wissahickon. It's snap.
32 trying to get
there. Trying
back.
To get there, he is.
Missed tackle.
It's fumble.
Fumble Ruski.
It looks like Upper Elbin got the ball back.
Absolutely.
Let's see what happens.
There was a scuffle. The dust will clear, and we'll see who came up victorious with the ball.
Upper Elbin fans happy here.
I'm sure they are.
Upper Elbin will get the ball back.
Upper Elbin with their third fumble recovery this game.
Very good job by the Upper Elbin defense.
Fantastic job. The time is 3 minutes and 8 seconds remaining. Upper Dublin getting set on their own 38-yard line. It's first and 10. 2 minutes, 40 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
The high snap handed off, and it looks like he won't get that far.
Julian Gimble hands off the ball.
Good game for Upper Dublin. I do have to admit it. This was a good game, despite the special teams.
Wissahickon did make an effort in the fourth quarter. They did score a touchdown. They did get on the board. It's better than no points at all against this Upper Dublin defense. Julian Gimble in the shotgun formation. High snap! It's a fumble!
High snap! It's fumble! Let's see!
Julian Gimble will recover the fumble.
Not good by Upper Dublin here.
Nasty snap from Upper Dublin. If the defense would have recovered that fumble, that would have been an easy touchdown. And despite the time of the game, that still would not be good for Upper Dublin.
Seriously, I mean, it's very embarrassing when you have the ball from a fumble and you're all excited and then your offense makes a gaffe like this, makes a mistake like this. It's just embarrassing.
That fumble will bring us back to the 11th yard line. Third and 37. Third and very long. Very, very, very long. 1 minute left in the clock.
This clock is starting. 57 seconds left in this ball game.
They're just going to wind down.
The clock is expiring.
I'm guessing they're going to wind down the clock just near, you know. There's nothing that could happen within 48 seconds.
We'll see what Gimble does. It looks like they're running out the clock. The snap.
And he needs it. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for joining us today on this edition of Friday Night Football.
I'm Josh Portney.
I'm Justin Zatelli.
And we thank you very much.
And let's just break down this game as they are just needing the ball. The thing that I noticed the most, the special teams had a very tough game. That was the only flaw I really saw.
I got to say, I completely agree with you. The defense did amazing with those fumble recoveries. They had an amazing game bringing this team to 5-0.
I'm very glad that we have this win, an away win, which makes it even worse.
As the teams line up,
thank you for joining us on this very victorious night here in Wissahickon. Upper Dublin, 37, Wissahickon, 6.
Go Cards!
We finish the game here in Trump Stadium, and we thank you for your viewership, and we welcome you for the next broadcast as soon as the next game is. Well, we'll see you next week. This is Josh Portney.
I'm Justin Zatelli.
And that was Ryan Levinson. Thank you very much for joining you on behalf of the entire Upper Dublin Network, channel network here. We thank you very much.